for Paranormal Safety New Class. Pen is huge.
Thank you.
Number 70, check out Todd. Subscribe to Circus MV. This is year 2011.
I'm Paranormal Investigator Chris Denman, and the pen is huge.
I'm John Tenney, a novelistic researcher from Realm of the Weird, Paranormal State, the New Class, and
in the hall. There's no time to waste. I better make some calls. I gotta get ready, make everything right, 'cause all my rowdy friends are ghosts hunting tonight. Hey, round up the team, let's get started. Hey, this is Brother Mike. There's a party and you're invited. We got the camera set, let's turn off these lights, 'cause all my rowdy friends are ghosts hunting tonight. Has a long history. It should be real, real good for activity. And we got the house wired for sound and got motion alarm setting all around. Got a box full of batteries ready to go, and everyone's itching to start this show. Got our logo tees, driving black SUVs, and that one bald guy with a slick goatee. Hey, round up the team, let's get started. Hey, this is Brother Mike. Well, there's a party and you're invited. We got the camera set, let's turn off these lights, 'cause all my rowdy friends are ghosts hunting tonight. Hey, round up the team, let's get started. Hey, this is your big brother Mike calling. There's a party and you're invited. We got the camera set, let's turn off these lights, 'cause all my rowdy friends are ghosts hunting tonight. That's right. Go get 'em, boys!
Would be.
Hey, hi everybody. Now that you can hear us, welcome to PEMA TV. We're not just yakety yakking like that no more.
Yeah, we really are.
Anyway, be sure and everybody, there should be a link going across the ticker underneath the screen to help us help the fort. Fort Mifflin does need a lot of help. So anything you can give, $1, $2, 50 cents, whatever you can transfer, please go to that link.
Save the fort that saved America.
Yep, save the fort that saved America. Fort Mifflin has been involved in almost every war except the ones that we fought in Europe. So, a lot can be said about that fort. And it just, the location just needs some help. That's all it is. Secondly, as of sometime tonight-ish, and don't you love my time frame, definitely by tomorrow afternoon, we will have Metaluna Boutique and Stones will be online and up and running.
And yeah, Kim, baby.
And Kim is so excited about that. Be sure and check us out. We'll have all of our items on there, or as many as I can force feed my computer to take. We'll have them up there in for sale, so be sure and stop by and check us out.
And I don't have the heart to tell them I have a ton more things. Yes,
oh, see, I already knew that. I've just got to get this. Joann, are you there?
Hi, everybody. I'm here. How y'all doing?
Doing really well. How have you been up there? Has the weather been treating y'all okay up there?
The weather has actually been awesome. I think summer disappeared.
Anybody ask, Joann is one of the driving forces, if not the driving force, behind the Kelly Little Green Men Days Festival.
And this is the go-to.
I don't know about that. I'm just part of the committee.
This is the go-to woman. Yeah. If she's not moving, call 911 because this woman never sits.
Yeah. How many days
Good
does
point.
It? How many days does it take to you recover after that festival?
Usually about a week.
I was going to say, probably, yeah, because, I mean, you guys do such an awesome job there. I mean, the first year, you kind of figured a few things out. The second year, last year went by just, I mean, without a hitch, and then this year, I can't wait. We can't wait to get up there. We've already got our rooms reserved, too, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
So we are so excited for this year. We have so much planned.
Well, give everybody a little dose of what they can expect this year.
Well, we'll get into a little bit more detail on everything, but the general synopsis, Friday night, August 16th, from 5 to 9 p.m., of course, we always have our opening ceremonies, the Pledge of Allegiance, the National Anthem, the opening prayer, and then a welcome from our community president, Frank Brown. And then Geraldine Sutton Stiff will take the stage, and she is the daughter of Elmer Lucky Sutton, who was in the house where the aliens had visited in August of 1955. So she's going to tell us the story of the Little Green Men as told to her by her father. And then Friday night, we have our Glennie Langford Outdoor Gospel Sing. Glennie Langford was Lucky Sutton's mother, a very devout Christian woman, so we dedicated our gospel sing to her. And our gospel sing this year, we've got Chloe Goss. She's a gorgeous, cute little 13-year-old gospel singer with a booming voice. And then we close out the gospel sing with the Donnie Harris Praise and Worship Ministries. And then we'll just have a little bit of local talent. We'll have our vendor booths open, and at 9 o'clock, we'll light up our spaceship. And then we come back on Saturday, and we are so, so excited for Saturday. 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., we're going to start off the day, hit the ground rolling. We've got the Battle of the Bands competition. From the time we start the festival up until 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we've got bands from all over the place battling it out for a huge prize package. They get money, they get studio time, they get their picture taken, and then the winner of the Battle of the Bands is going to be the opening act for our headliner, Peyton Taylor, out of Nashville, Tennessee. In between all of that, we've got our awesome alien costume contest with huge prizes. We've got trivia. We've got food. We've got games. We've got rides for the kids. It's going to be an awesome day.
Do I get to volunteer to be a judge again for the costumes?
We would love to have you as a judge for the costume contest again.
We had fun with that and the cake decorating. We had fun judging those last year, Cynthia and I.
We're not doing the cake decorating this year. We have so many other things planned. We can't do everything every year.
Right.
But this year, the costume contest is going to be huge because our sponsor, Peg Hayes from Hayes Furniture here in Hopkinsville, has donated some awesome prizes.
Oh, nice.
So we are going just to have kids and adults putting on their alien costumes and crawling out of the woodwork. Because the first prize in the adult costume contest is a $500 gift certificate to Herb Hayes Furniture. And then the kids, first prize there is a children's size recliner. Second prize is a children's bean bag. Third prize is a children's colored cube. And the first 10 people that enter the costume contest, no matter what age group they're in, they also get a $50 gift certificate to Herb Hayes.
Wow, those are some great prizes this year.
They are. Peggy Hayes and Herb Hayes Furniture has been with us since the first festival, and they are just awesome. And this year, she went above and beyond.
Oh, absolutely. And yes, I love being one of the judges for that. That was so much fun.
Yeah. Oh, and we love just documenting and having it out online where people can actually go to our YouTube channel right now if you want to get a sample of what we're going to be doing. In exactly
2 weeks.
It's in 2 weeks, but I was going to say 15 days.
2 weeks from tonight.
Right.
The festival will be going on 2 weeks from tonight.
We've got last year's musical entertainment.
Actually.
Is up on YouTube right now. And some of Aaron Houdini's stuff that he did there at the festival last year.
Actually, it's not even 2 weeks from tonight because in Kentucky, it's already over with.
No, in Kentucky, it's only 8:30.
It is still 8:30.
It will be on until 9 o'clock.
Okay, so you still got 30 minutes in 2 weeks.
Yep. But while all your fans are out there trolling YouTube, they can also find the YouTube video of our flying saucer.
That's right.
That we have on YouTube also.
Yep.
And we have the opening of it, or the presentation of it last year, the beginning of it.
I think so.
Yeah,
the media reveal. Yes.
Yeah, Cynthia had the video camera out there.
Yeah.
Mhm.
So yeah, I mean, people need to understand that this is small town America. This is the way the rest of the country ought to act. And I've said that from the get go. Well, we're just blessed to be involved with you guys in this festival because you guys just do it the right way. You know, you guys are a small town pulling yourself up by your bootstraps, and that's got to be commended and mentioned. You know.
Oh, and let me tell you, the food there rocks.
Yeah. Except for the stew. I haven't had the stew yet.
Yeah, we never got the alien stew.
I'm going to have some alien stew this year. I'm already put that on the bucket list.
No way.
Well, not really. We did the alien stew the first year. I mean, that was the premiere of the alien stew for the premiere festival. But, I mean, some things you just can't repeat. It was just so good, we don't want to repeat it and mar anything. And honestly, it's the middle of summer. A hot bowl of stew? Come on.
Yeah, but a hot bowl of green stew?
I tried getting them to make it green, but, you know.
Yeah, well, I can always hope maybe somebody will sneak me a bowl, you know, kind of sideways, get me a bowl in there.
Okay, I have to ask, do we have the fried pickle guy back again this year?
Do we have who?
The guy who did the fried pickles.
Barbecue guys?
No, not the barbecue guys. There was a I want to say the red trailer of food. They did fried pickles.
Oh, I know who you mean. Yes, they changed names. That's why I didn't recognize it. But yeah, they'll be back this year.
Nice.
Even more booth vendors and stuff this year too.
We always keep the same amount of food vendors. That way, everyone gets a good selection, but there's not 1,000 food vendors. We want our vendors, we want to keep it small. We want the vendors to make their money.
Right,
okay? But we make sure we have all different kinds. We never repeat the variety of food. So once we're signed up with a barbecue vendor, we don't accept another barbecue vendor. This year we've got barbecue, we've got fish, we've got Mexican, we've got hot dogs, we've got sausage, we've got steak sandwiches, I believe.
I don't know, the hot dogs were good last
year. We got the one that has the fried pickles. I know one vendor is doing chocolate or deep fried chocolate covered cheesecake. That's one I gotta hit up.
Oh
yeah, well, I'm gonna have to give that a shot too. And plus it's a festival, it's a fair, it's where you eat stuff like that. You only do it once a year, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
We only do it once a year in Kelly, Kentucky.
Well, that's true.
And we do it all weekend long.
I don't know if I could do it more than once a year. I am wore out, and the festival's not even here yet.
Well, I'm going to ask this, and if you can't tell me, just, you know, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, let me know. But you guys have always had a very interesting way of having at least one guest show up. The first year, you had the huge... the 12-door pickup truck limo that dropped off the Star Entertainment. Last year, there was the EMT helicopter that landed, and I think a couple of aliens got out of the helicopter, if I'm not mistaken. And
yeah.
I was curious how you guys were going to, if there's any hints you can give us as to how people are showing up.
Well, I don't think we have the limo this year.
No.
But I do know there's a helicopter. I do know that the 38-foot flying saucer is going to be there. And I do know there's a brand new batch of aliens. And, you know, the strange thing is, there's been alien sightings around town. And pictures are starting to flow in. There's been some aliens seen walking around at some businesses, so they're around already. But I do know there's a brand new family of aliens that are going to show up that day.
Yeah. And
there's always the trusty train.
Yeah. Train always. Trains keep it rolling.
The train loves us. Those conductors go by and they're just waving and it's a great day.
Okay. With the musical entertainment, now I know you've already, we had talked a little bit earlier that it's a battle of the band scenario, but it's not a double elimination tournament. These guys basically have one shot, right?
They have one shot. We're using an enhanced grading system. The way most battle of the bands competition work, you come in, you sing one song, and then you've got... All of that in 30 minutes is the only chance they have to impress the judges. So it's going to be intense.
Yeah. Yeah, having that type of format, I mean, it makes sense for a one day. But, I mean, that really does put the pressure on them.
It does.
Hey, bring your A game or get out of the pool.
Yeah. Come stronger.
Bring your A game and prove to us why you deserve the prize.
Right.
And let me tell you, we got some judges.
Oh, I can imagine.
We got a celebrity panel of judges for the Battle of the Bands contest. We haven't dropped any names, so anyone knows who they are. But in fairness to the bands bringing their all, we're bringing our all to the judges panel.
Yeah.
We've got a pop singer. We've got a country music singer. We have a band manager. And we have a recording studio owner who is a former musician himself.
Nice.
But we've got the quality on the judging panel, so those bands need to have the quality on the stage.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. What and what was the guy's, was his name Jonathan Carter? Wasn't he the one that sounded?
Jordan Carter was there last year.
Yeah, sounded exactly like a young Johnny Cash. It was scary. Scary.
He did. He sounded so good.
Because I've played just the audio of that tape, of that performance for some people, and I said, this guy's going to sound like Johnny Cash, and I get the yeah, whatever, and I play it, and they go, oh, holy crap. Because, yes,
we were walking across the festival field, heading over to judge one of the costume contests, and he started singing, and I kid you not, I mean, there were dozens of people that just stopped walking and turned around to see who was really on stage. Yeah. He was just that good.
Yeah, and I mean, that just goes to show the caliber of entertainment you guys get, because he was great. I mean, all the guys last year were great. But I mean, he was top of the mark. I mean, I really enjoyed what he was doing.
Oh, he was nice. He works at the Fontenelle down there in Nashville, which is, what's that, the Loretta Lynn Ranch, I believe?
Yep.
He's one of the singing waiters.
Wow. Yeah, he's got an amazing voice. I'm sure it won't be long, and we'll be hearing a whole lot more about him.
Oh, yeah.
And there were a few last year that really were good.
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying. They were all great last year, but he was... In my opinion, because I like Johnny Cash a lot, so just in my opinion.
Okay.
He was memorable. They were all good, but he was memorable.
Yeah. That's a good way of putting it. I like that.
I don't know. I think the most memorable part was the 6'9" guy who had to put the mic stand on a chair so it would get near his face. Yeah.
He was so tall. He's like 6'10".
Right?
Yeah.
That was Matt Marinchek. He was actually a former OSU basketball star and gave up basketball in order to do country music.
Yeah.
Might explain the heist, too.
Yeah. I just turned around and there's this little... his partner who like comes up to about mid chest on him, and then he's standing there and he actually had to pick up the mic and put it on the chair, and I just busted up. It's like, poor guy, he can't even get a mic stand that high.
Yeah. Oh goodness. But well, and this year the winner of the Battle of the Bands not only gets, you mentioned the prizes that they get, but they also get to perform first for your lead act, which is
Peyton Taylor. She is, oh my gosh, you should see a picture of her. She is a beautiful young lady, absolutely gorgeous. She was the 2011 Texaco Country Showdown finalist, and she will be taking the stage at 7:30, and she'll play until the festival closes at 9 o'clock. But she's done some great things in her career, too. She's opened for names that we all know and love. Pam Tillis, Lori Morgan, Charlie Daniels. I mean, she's quite the up-and-comer. She had her first CD come out in 2011, and I believe her second CD either just came out or is getting ready to come out.
Awesome. Have you guys, you have links, and I've been showing this on and off, but I have a link to the website, thekellykentucky.com/festivals/littlegreenmenfestival.html. Anyway, that link's up there for people that need to, if you want to find out more about the exact sponsors, hotel room information is on there too, I believe.
There's all sorts of information on the website. We put all of our advertisers and sponsors and everyone up there. And one of our sponsors this year is a hotel, Hampton Inn and Suites here in Hopkinsville.
Yeah, yeah. This is, I mean, it's just, like we've said before, this is such a well-organized and well-run festival. You know, between you and Frank Brown, I mean... it's just amazing how smooth it is. We've put on one convention ourselves, so we
Marcus, we feel your pain, yeah. Trust me.
And then to make it smooth for that many more people, you know, that's just a bonus.
Well, we have a great team working with us. I mean, it's not just me and Frank. I mean, Frank's the community president. He is awesome. Teresa Knight and I are co-chairs at the festival this year. It was just getting too big for one person to handle. And then behind that, there's a committee of another 20 people, and it takes every one of us most of our waking hours to pull this off.
But we, in the forefront, the two you see scrambling, and he love Frank, but he gets chauffeured around a little bit in the runabout. Joann, on the other hand, this woman, you have to be quick to catch her. If you're not quick, she's gone.
Oh, I don't stay in one place very long. But let me tell you what, okay? This year, I'm going to be scrambling more than normal because, and if, when Frank hears this broadcast, he's probably going to come over here and knock me upside my head, okay? But this year, Frank's daughter decided her wedding day was going to be the day of the festival.
Oh, no.
So most of Saturday, Frank's not going to be here. We tried to convince them to get married on the stage. We got the aliens. We can have an alien officiate the wedding.
Right.
No problem. We just didn't want to let go of Frank.
Right.
But no, Frank's not going to be there. He'll be there Friday night. He'll be there Saturday night. But family's family. He's got other stuff to do Saturday morning. So Joann's going to be on her feet and running around in circles three different ways.
Ladies and gentlemen, send flowers to Joann now. She's going to need them. So, well, at least if he's off busy Saturday, maybe you'll get to be chauffeured around a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, I doubt that. I got to keep control of my Battle of the Bands competition.
Yeah.
I'm going to be sticking pretty close to the stage this year.
And they don't drive fast enough to keep up with you anyway.
No, even with my bum knee, I outrun that thing.
I know. I've watched it.
That was in a leg brace last year. This year, I don't have the brace on. I'll bring it with me, but I don't have it on.
Is the layout of how, is the location going to change, or is it the same place as last year?
No, it's in the same place as last year. We've rearranged the parking lots a little bit. We've slid the stage more to the right, but for the most part, it's pretty much the same layout as last year.
Okay.
I'm trying to figure... More to the right
just means
it'll be closer to the road.
That keeps people from parking on the septic tank.
Yep.
Pretty much, yes. Yeah.
Yeah, because that's where the trailer will be, right in front of all that.
Right.
So, yeah, okay, that makes a lot of sense, actually.
I was just trying to get my bearings. That's all good.
Yeah.
Do we have more of the crafter-type vendors this year?
We have the same amount of space, so we'll have about the same amount of craft vendors, and then we'll have what we call other vendors on the outskirts. Remember last year we had the big fighter jet, and
mm-hmm.
We'll have the police department command station and the fire trucks. We got rides for the kids again this year. So, I mean, you've got your rows of small vendors. I mean, small is a bad word. I don't mean to belittle them, but you have your rows of tents for the vendors.
Right.
And then you also have your activity vendors all the way around.
That's going to be awesome. That does sound a lot better.
Yeah, there was one vendor I was after last year, and I never did get there. I don't remember what it was. There was blinky lights. I don't know.
You have to forgive her. She gets distracted by the shiny stuff sometimes.
They were back in the corner.
Oh, I'm going to go get a burrito. Ooh, shiny.
Right. Yeah. 3 hours later.
Hey,
yeah.
To my defense, though, I was not the one who fell in the hole. It was my partner.
That's very true.
Who wound up with a sprained ankle last year, not me.
Yeah, that's very true. And Cynthia did heal up, just so everybody knows.
She did. Poor Cynthia.
Minor injury. Have you guys...
We felt so bad, but we made sure all those holes are filled in. We're already over there working.
And Cynthia thanks you.
Yeah. You guys, you know, this thing has grown and almost doubled in size, or a little more than doubled in size every year. What are your guys' future plans for this? Where do you guys see this going?
To the moon, Alice, to the moon.
You know, I was just curious.
Well, our ultimate goal, I mean, and right from the beginning of the festival back in 2011, we've said this, our ultimate goal with the festival as a fundraiser is to build a community park for the residents here that'll have a learning center with computer stations in it to help kids with their schoolwork, and have a fire department substation where a fire truck can park their vehicle for better response time here, because we don't have a fire department, and on each side of us, we only have volunteer departments. Mm-hmm. But once we get the park built, then we're talking about a bigger festival. More room, different parking, more activities, permanent sites. Right. But for now, we just want to keep it country fair style, country festival.
Right. And to be honest with you, there is absolutely nothing, you guys do absolutely nothing wrong. Don't get me wrong. This, I mean, you guys put on one of the best run, most organized festivals I think I've ever seen. You know, the especially the bands get in and all, on and off on time. It's being a middle manager, I respect the logistics behind what you've got going on. And it's, like I said, we have an awesome time, and we've been blessed that you guys have invited us to be part of this.
Well, and to the absolutely to their benefit, we do a lot of larger events, mm-hmm. a lot of different types of events, conventions. Little Green Men, we've been committed to since year one, and this is the one we look forward to every year.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Oh, we so appreciate you guys coming. We love having you out. And in all honesty, it doesn't run as smooth as what we let everyone see. There's times when Joann disappears behind the stage to talk to a band, I'm back there pulling my hair out.
Right.
But Nothing
ever goes the way it's supposed to.
True.
From
but
a visitor's
as long as everybody has fun, we don't sweat the little details.
Right.
Well, from a visitor's point of view, though, everything always runs great. Yeah. I mean, we've seen little things behind the scenes, but overall, I mean, we've seen bigger places have a lot worse going on, and
that's right.
Everything kind of crumble halfway through it. And like I said, you're the one we've stayed committed to. We've been to mm-hmm. a whole bunch of different ones. Some we've been back a second year, but that's it. This is our third year with you guys.
Yeah.
Well, we love having you out. We so appreciate those kind words, too. It really does mean a lot to know that people notice it runs, that we're not just a bunch of hillbillies out here trying to make a buck.
Exactly, and there's something else that people need to keep in mind, and like I said, I mentioned this earlier, you guys are doing what the country needs to do, in my humble, furry opinion.
Bring back community to the community.
That's right. It takes a whole village to raise a child, and right now, we can't get people off their cell phones long enough to, I mean...
Talk to the person sitting next to
we
them.
We actually went out to eat tonight, and when you go to sit at a table, and you look at a table, a family of six sitting at a table... And there's one person up looking around, and that's because their phone's downloading something. And the other five people are just on their phone. And what's bad is the kids are probably talking to each other. And that's what
it's sad. Between the cell phones and the computers and the video games, people have lost touch with not just reality, but each other.
Yeah.
And it's sad. We love when people come out there, because you don't see that many cell phones at the festival.
No.
You see them on the hips, you see them in the back pocket, whatever, but people are enjoying the festival. They're meeting their neighbors, they're meeting people from out of town, and they're having fun as a family.
Yep. Exactly.
Well,
and that's...
Well, that and the spaceship, where it's placed every year, is placed in a specific spot, so where it cuts all bars.
Mm-hmm. All
cell phone reception is knocked out as long as the spaceship has landed.
But, you know, like
spaceship
I said...
Spaceship has landed.
Like I said, it's been a privilege for us to be involved. Just because, like I said, this is what we need to be doing.
Absolutely.
This is what we need to be doing to help each other, help the country, help it would help everything. If people did stuff like this around the world all the time, it'd be a lot less wars, a lot less fighting over this, or my religion's better than yours, or whatever. It's just people coming together for a community to help the community. And leaving differences aside. It's just a great thing to see.
I mean, everyone here in Kelly is such a close-knit community. We're a family, and we share that. I mean, our festival helps us share that point of view and let people know that it's still okay to love your kids. It's still okay to be seen with your parents, no matter how geeky you think they are. But, I mean, that's our whole point of view. Let's give back to the community. Let's bring everyone together in friendship and fellowship.
Yeah, exactly.
And fried pickles.
And cornhole. Y'all going to have another cornhole tournament this year?
We're not having a cornhole tournament, but we will have the cornhole boards out there, small size for the kids to play with. The big one that we had out there last year went to the winner of the cornhole board competition last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, because...
Y'all ever going to do any horseshoes? I'm just curious.
Well, I don't know. Horseshoes hurt when you get those unruly kids that want to throw them in four different directions.
I said sorry.
But... we'll have lots of fun and games, and we've got some different rides coming out. We'll have the alien bouncer out there again for the kids. And then we're getting some different rides than last year. So there'll be some other rides out there and pictures taken with the spaceship. And the spaceship will be lit both nights. So, awesome. I mean, we're going to have fun with that, too.
Yeah, that was actually quite impressive last year when they lit that thing off. That was actually very, very impressive.
With the smoke and the music and all that other stuff.
Yeah, that was cool. I like that.
We like
that. I tell you, just looking at that thing sitting in a field, it's 38 foot around. So this thing is huge to a little kid standing in front of it in daylight.
Right.
And when that thing lit up and then the music started and the smoke started going and the lights, everyone just stopped. There was nothing but music and crickets for miles around.
Yes, and that's true. That's all there was, because their kids weren't even going. I mean, their chins were on the floor or on the ground. They couldn't believe what they was looking at.
Well, even when they pass by it during the day, it's like, okay, yeah, it's a big spaceship. Okay, we see the green men. But at night, when the smoke and the lights and everything started, that it was a whole different atmosphere.
Yeah, when those little guys coming down the ramp start casting shadows and stuff from the light behind them, that has a whole another level to it. It's cool. People should come out just to see that. You know?
It's awesome. We invite everyone to come out, no matter where you're from. And we've had inquiries from literally all over the world. I mean, we've gotten emails from people in Australia, Chechnya. I mean, people that never heard of Kelly, Kentucky are inquiring about the festival and planning their vacations around it now.
Yeah. Well, and that's what you guys want. I mean, that's what's going to grow it and build it and make it, you know, let it be what it's going to be to its fullest extent.
Well, we'll get it there. I mean, it's all for the benefit of the community. So the more people that come out and support us, the better we can support our community.
Well,
actually, this year, we are giving back to a community as part of this year's festival. We are supporting Project Believe in Me, which is an anti-bullying campaign. So this year, part of the proceeds from the festival are going to help prevent bullying, not here in our own town. We got a handle on that. It's going to help the anti-bullying campaign nationwide.
Right. And that is I'm not going to say an epidemic, but there have that will help a lot of people.
Yep. And one of our guest speakers this year, and I'm even going to venture to call him a guest star, remember from the first festival, young little teenager Tyler Model was our open, was our headliner. He's the one that rolled in that limo.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Well, he has gotten huge. He's run red carpets everywhere from Texas to California and New York. He has made a name for himself in the music industry. He actually worked with Project Believe in Me and wrote a song for their CD called Hold On Another Day. He's coming back this year to tell us about Project Believe in Me and sing the song that he wrote for the campaign, and just to talk to the kids and let them know bullying is not okay. There are people that believe in you, and there are things you can do to prevent it, to report it, and to make sure you're not a victim of it.
I still have my glow-in-the-dark Tyler Model wristband from the first one.
Yeah.
I have mine, too.
Hey, they were cool.
Have you guys...
They are.
Have you guys... with all the talent that's coming in, is there going to be another celebrity tent like there was last year?
Is there going to be what?
A quote-unquote celebrity-style tent where the people can go meet the entertainers one-to-one?
Yes. This year it's actually going to be closer over to the stage. That way people know where to find the musicians. But there is going to be the artist tent where the artists will sit and do autographs and sell their merchandise. And they'll be practicing in between the band competition. And they'll all be there.
Right, right. Okay. Oh, no, I was just curious because that was kind of an added benefit last year. I mean, people, once they knew where the tent was, people started going over there in droves. But it was kind of nice to be able to go over and, you know, from my point of view, up there recording everything, it's nice to be able to get up and walk around and go down there and talk to them without having to, hey, how are you doing, blah, blah, and scream because you're not near the PA system anymore. It was just, it's a more relaxed way to interact with them. And it was great. I mean, I loved it.
And a lot of people take our festival flyers that have all the artists' pictures on it, and they take the flyers and get the autographs of everybody, too, because 10 years from now, you don't know where some of these people are going to be.
Right.
You may have one of the first autographs in existence.
Right. That's true. That's very, very true.
Like Kayla and Tyler the first year.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Kayla's making a name for herself, too. I talked to her the other day. They're coming down for a visit. They're not playing at the festival this year, but she said they're going to be here every year. She just wants to come and have fun.
Yeah. Well, and that's like I said, that's the great thing is that if you can't have fun at Little Green Men Days, there's something wrong with you, not Little Green Men Days. That's
right.
All I can tell you.
Right.
Because, I mean, it's just like you said, it's a family atmosphere. You know, it's community coming together, it's the fellowship that's there, it's just nice to be part of.
Well, and even the competition isn't competition.
Yeah.
All the vendors, I mean, they're all milling around and buying from each other and sharing all
they
silly
are. They're
stuff
talking to each other, oh, you were at this festival, maybe I'll try this festival, give me your phone number, let's be Facebook friends. It isn't come over here and buy from me and not from her.
Right.
Even the vendors end up being friends.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're like, oh, I don't have your size, but if you go over there, then they probably have it.
Yeah. I noticed that at my booth, because I also have a vendor booth set up. And no, I don't have it. Go over and talk to this one, or this person sent me over here. Do you have any of this left? And it's great. Everyone gets along. We didn't have any vendors fighting or arguing. We had vendors that stayed overnight at the festival, rather than go down to a motel because, oh, you're staying? Well, we'll stay too, and we'll sit here and we'll drink coffee all night long.
Right.
I mean, a lot of people ended up making new friends, which is our goal.
Right.
It's all about friendship.
And the Holiday, is it the Holiday Inn? Yeah, the Holiday Inn is filling up quick. So anybody interested, if you want to stay at the Holiday Inn, you better get a hold of them. Because they were almost out of rooms the other night when I called.
Yeah,
are the
Holiday Inn books up quick, and our sponsor this year is the Hampton Inn and Suites, and I don't know how many rooms they have left. I know most of the hotels book up quick to be to the festival.
Well, I'm thinking if the sponsor hotel was getting that close to filling up and Holiday Inn is filling up, then we're running out of space in town. So if you want a hotel room, you better make some calls quick.
Are the bands?
Yeah.
Are the bands going to get abducted off of stage again this year?
No, but rumor has it Peyton will be.
Nice.
No, we can't abduct the bands off because they're only up there for 30 minutes to begin with, and it is a competition. But Peyton's playing for an hour and a half, so I'm sure the aliens are going to abduct her just like they have in past years, so she can take a break and get a drink.
And Darth Vader should be there this year, shouldn't he?
I believe Darth Vader's going to be there, and one of the stormtroopers.
Yeah, I thought it was a stormtrooper, so yeah.
Nice.
That skit was cute last year.
Yeah, it was.
That was great.
Yeah, it was. Anything else anything else new or exciting you want to mention to everybody? Because we are kind of getting here towards the end of this. Do you have anything else you want to let anybody know about or how they can contact you guys? I know I've been putting your link up to the website page, but is there anything else? Y'all are on Facebook for sure, right?
We're on Facebook. They can go to our website, kellygreenman.com. All of our information's there, and the history is there. And then we also have our Facebook page titled Kelly Little Green Men Days. And that stays up to the minute. I'm constantly posting stuff on there for everybody. And then, of course, even if you're coming from out of town, get in on this costume contest.
Yeah.
The paperwork is on our website, or you can fill out your entry form at the festival. We'll have it there in the main tent. Join the fun. I don't care if you're coming from Indiana. Create a costume, because this thing is going to be huge.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm coming all the way from Texas to judge it, so show up, people.
Yeah.
Come on up.
I would make myself a tinfoil hat, but that's a lot of tinfoil.
Well, we don't know about the tinfoil. That was just a rumor that was created down there in Area 51.
You don't know if it works or not. If it works, for
we
sure.
We don't know if it works. We'll have to ask the aliens when they get there this year.
Yeah, remind me.
I will make you a tinfoil hat and bring it to you at the festival.
And
we'll see if the aliens come over and bother you.
And I know you will.
And I'll get a picture and prove it to everyone, too.
Yeah, I will post it on every Facebook we have.
I will never wear it down. Just make it attractive. Put a feather in it or something. I don't know. Well, Joann, thank you.
Well, I can't wait to see you guys there again. You guys you make the festival memorable. Help us bring it to the world, and we really, really appreciate you helping us out every year.
Well, it's totally our pleasure. And we want to thank you so much for taking time out of your busy Friday night, especially 2 weeks before. I know you guys are doing something every day for that festival. So to take time to come talk
Pretty
to
much.
Us, we appreciate it. So.
Oh, thank you.
So, yes, we will be there, and Cynthia plans on being there, too, like she has every year.
We might have to wrap her in bubble wrap, but she'll be there, too.
No, they filled in the hole. She'll be fine.
So.
All right, guys. We'll see you in 2 weeks, okay?
Thank you
so much, Joann.
Thank you. Have a good evening.
You too. Bye-bye.
Night.
Bye-bye.
All right, everybody. Before we get out of here. Once again, please, the link that you will see scrolling across the bottom, please help us help the fort. I'm going to leave that link running all weekend. Help us help the fort that saved America. Help us help Fort Mifflin. Anything that you can give to help is greatly appreciated.
And, again, by sometime tomorrow afternoon at the latest, Metaluna should be online with pictures and prices and little clicky buttons.
And hopefully some shipping stuff and everything. We're going to try to make that happen. No, it'll happen. I don't have any choice. It's got to happen.
I got wounded today. It better happen.
Oh, my goodness. Whew. Do you want to show, before we leave, so it's documented for history,
yes,
do you want to show
Mary,
everybody your boo-boo?
I'll show Mary my boo-boo. See my regular finger? Now look at the other one. See the difference? This is what happens when you make jewelry.
And I told her there's dirt outside. Just rub a little dirt on it. It's not a weight-bearing bone. You'll be fine.
No. It hurts. It don't bend.
So I'm going to go get her a twizzly straw and some apple juice, and she'll be okay. Once
a
again.
Grape slush.
I didn't marry Mountain Man. Trust me. No. Okay, folks. Once again, thank you for joining us for our craziness. 2 weeks. We will not be live because we'll be at what we were just talking about. We'll be at Little Green Men Festival.
But tune in Monday.
Tune in Monday on Just Saying because they are talking too.
I have no idea. I have to get my book.
And No Idea is a great, great guest. He talks about stuff like you wouldn't believe.
Oh, why do you gotta be like that? Okay. Ooh. Oh, looky there. Who does that say?
What?
It's that one right there.
Is that who it is?
It is. Actually, Monday is Mary and my 1 year anniversary with Just Saying. Mm-hmm. Our special guest is Debbie Branning.
Debbie is awesome.
We love
Debbie.
They
did this really cool thing at a cemetery. It's awesome.
Not only the cemetery. She does the cemetery crawl. They all kinds of stuff.
I know. I'm just saying. It's cool.
But yes, join us Monday. Join us every night, but especially Monday.
Yep, we got live shows every night of the week, folks. Every night of the week, except Saturdays. And the ones on Saturdays are super awesome, and they're on autoplay. So tune in anytime, because I know people have got busy schedules.
Then if you don't have busy schedules?
Pretend you have a busy schedule and
we
tune in.
We have some cool old commercials. Come in, sit down, enjoy the commercials.
Yeah, that's for sure.
It happens.
All right, let's get out of here.
Say goodnight.
Good night, Mary.
Good night, Mary.
Wired for sound and got motion alarm setting all around. Got a box full of batteries ready to go. And everyone's itching to start this show. Got our logo tees, driving black SUVs. And that one bald guy with a slick goatee. Hey, round up the tee. Let's get Brother Mike, well there's a party and you're invited. We got the camera set, let's turn off these lights. Cause all my rowdy friends are ghost hunting tonight. Hey, round up the team, let's get started. Hey, this is your big brother Mike calling. There's a party and you're invited. We got the camera set, let's turn on these lights. It's all my rider friends that goes hunting tonight. That's right. Go get them, boys!
Stop by and check us out.
And I don't have the heart to tell him I have a ton more things he has to
do. Oh, see, I already knew that. I've just got to get this. Joann, are you there?
Hi, everybody. I'm here. How y'all doing?
Doing really well. How have you been up there? Has the weather been treating y'all okay up there?
The weather has actually been awesome. I think summer disappeared.
Everybody ask, Joann is one of the driving forces, if not the driving force, behind the Kelly Little Green Men Days Festival.
And this is the go-to.
I don't know about that. I'm just part of the committee.
This is the go-to woman. Yeah. If she's not moving, call 911 because this woman never sits.
Yeah. How many days
Good
does
point.
It? How many days does it take to recover after that festival?
Usually about a week.
Because, I mean, you guys do such an awesome job there. I mean, the first year you kind of figured a few things.
Like a man, Lord, that lamb just moved on that stand. I got movement in the cellars, I got footsteps in the hall. There's no time to waste, I better make some calls. I gotta get ready, make everything right, 'cause all my rowdy friends are ghost hunting tonight. Hey, round up the team, let's get started. Hey, this is Brother Mike. There's a party and you're invited. We got the camera set, let's turn off these lights, 'cause all my rowdy friends are ghost hunting tonight. Old house has a long history. It should be real, real good for activity. And we got the house.
Would be.
Hey, hi everybody. Now that you can hear us, welcome to PEMA TV. We're not just yakety yakking like that no more.
Yeah, we really are.
Anyway, be sure and everybody, there should be a link going across the ticker underneath the screen to help us help the fort. Fort Mifflin does need a lot of help. So anything you can give, $1, $2, 50 cents, whatever you can transfer, please go to that link.
Save the fort that saved America.
Yep, save the fort that saved America. Fort Mifflin has been involved in almost every war except the ones that we fought in Europe. So, a lot can be said about that fort. And it just, the location just needs some help. That's all it is. Secondly, as of sometime tonight-ish, and don't you love my time frame, definitely by tomorrow afternoon, we will have Metalona Boutique and Stones will be online and up and running.
And yeah, Kim, baby.
And Kim is so excited about that. Be sure and check us out. We'll have all of our items on there, or as many as I can force feed my computer to take. We'll have them up there in for sale. So be sure and